Have you ever made money and not know why you made money? Or perhaps you lost money, but you also do not know why you lost money. Now, trading is very difficult because it's not so clear, you know, it's not black and white. It's sometimes gray, meaning that you don't really know whether you are doing something right or, you know, you're just lucky. So in today's video, I want to talk about why trading is so difficult. Specifically, I want to cover the four outcomes of trading. Okay, when it comes to trading, there's only four outcomes. And if you understand each of these outcomes and you're able to tell, you know, which of these outcomes your trade is, it can help you become a better trader. So that's my goal for today's video. So let's go into what I will be covering about today. Now, the first thing I want to do is I want to talk about why you need to know the correct outcome. Okay, I don't just want to tell you the outcome. I want to show you why you need to know this. This is very important if you want to become a better trader. If you are still struggling and you want to find out certain weaknesses in your trading, then this is very important for you. So basically, there are four outcomes. So I'll go through each of them. Right, you have the good trade that wins money. You have the good trade that loses money. Then you have the bad trade that wins money and the bad trade that loses money. Now, of all these outcomes, the outcome number three is the outcome that you want to avoid at all costs. I'll go into more details about why this is so dangerous. But for now, these are the four outcomes. And if you stick to the end, I also want to show you how you know for sure which type of outcome your trade falls under. Because as I mentioned, you need to know where you are at. You need to understand what is your weaknesses when it comes to trading in order to become a better trader. Okay, so by the way, we also have a free day trading guide for you. So if you've not downloaded it, just check for the link in the description. I'll put it down so that you can download it. That free day trading guide will have a step-by-step trading system for you to get started, especially if you are new. At the same time, really appreciate you could just take 3 seconds just to like the video and hit the subscribe button, because we are on a mission to impact 100,000 traders, and we would really, really appreciate if you could help us get there. So let's go to the first part of today's video is, why do you need to know this? Why do I actually take the time to record a video like this? Very simple. Because if you do not analyze your trades and what kind of results you are getting, what kind of outcome, you cannot improve. Okay, what gets measured gets improved. So if you do not measure your trades, you do not understand what's making you money and what's losing you money, you cannot become a better trader. Okay, you do not just become a better trader just by trading. Okay, you need to put in the time to analyze your trades. So I have an example over here. So for example, if let's say you find that a lot of your winners, right, trades which are making money from, is not coming from good trades that win money. Okay, in a moment's time, I will define what does this good trade win money mean and what does a bad trade that win money means as well. But for now, right, let's say you realize that a lot of them comes from this, does not come from this, sorry, but instead comes from bad trades that win money. You can reasonably conclude that you were just lucky. So meaning that if you would have made money, it's not because you have a profitable strategy, it's because you are lucky. And this is very important, because if you are lucky, then you cannot expect to keep making money over and over again by doing this. Okay, but if it's really because you followed your trading system and it was a good trade, then you can reasonably conclude that your trading strategy is working, and therefore you will have the confidence to keep sticking to the trading strategy. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. The opposite is also true. Let's say you find that most of your losses come from a bad trade that lose money. So in this case, you know that because these are trades which you shouldn't have taken to begin with, then you can troubleshoot that, okay, perhaps you need to be more disciplined. So it's not your trading strategy, it's the fact that psychologically you are not disciplined and you are not sticking to your trading plan, and that explains your losses. So let's go into the first outcome that it's very obvious, it's very straightforward, I won't spend too much time. So the first outcome is you have a good trade that wins money. Very simple, you see a trade set up. So perhaps, you know, this is the charts and you are seeing that, you know, price is ranging and your plan is to buy when price breaks out here. So price breaks out here and you just execute the trade without hesitation and you put your stop loss and price goes up. And you made money, okay? You hit your take profit. Very straightforward. Good trade, win money. You follow your rules and you enter. You didn't hesitate. Stick to the plan and this trade made you money. So this is outcome number one. Nothing much to say about it. Outcome number two is the same thing in a sense that you back to the same scenario. You have the support and the resistance, and your plan was to buy when price breaks out. So price goes up, but instead of price going up, as per your trading plan, it comes back down and does a fake out. So you lost money. But here's the thing. This is still a good trade because you entered a trade that fits your criteria. So even though you lost money, you cannot consider it as a bad trade. Okay, this is why trading is so tricky, because you can have a good trade and lose money, but it's still nonetheless a good trade. Okay, doesn't mean that you lose money means it's a bad trade and you win money is a good trade. That's very important. Okay, I'll repeat it one more time. Doesn't mean that just because a trade made money means it's a good trade, and doesn't mean that if a trade lose money, it is a bad trade. Okay, it has to do with whether you follow your rules. Okay, that's what I'll cover at the end of this video. So this outcome number three is the one that I want to spend a little more time with. It is where you have a bad trade then win money. Now, this is a very, very dangerous outcome, as I'll explain to you shortly. So what is this outcome? It's very simple. You didn't, okay, very important. You didn't follow your trading plan, and you entered the trade because you were impatient, you know, you just wanted to trade, you just you were bored or whatever it is, okay? You just did not stick to your trading plan. Perhaps, you know, you follow our signals and you didn't follow our signals, or you enter our signals wrongly. Doesn't matter, you didn't follow the trading plan. Now, in this case, you were lucky, meaning that price went in your direction. Let's say you buy and price goes up. Now, here's the truth. Here's the hard truth about trading is that no matter what you do, any trade can go your way, okay? Any trade. When I mean any trade, I really mean any trade. Doesn't matter what instrument you trade, what time frame you trade. Even if you toss a coin, there is a probability that a price will go in your direction just by pure chance. Now, here's the thing. This is very dangerous because when you make money, you think that you did something right. So I mentioned over here, it appears that you did something right. Right, I mean, it's very common for you to think that way because you made money, right? As I said, win money, just because you won money doesn't mean it's a good trade. Just because you lost money doesn't mean it's a bad trade. So this is very dangerous because it seems like you did the right thing. But what happens is that you're actually doing the wrong thing because you are not following your trading plan. You are just trading haphazardly and you are not sticking to your plan. So what happens is that you are actually conditioning yourself, okay? You are building a bad habit. A very, very bad habit. And this will really make it very hard for you to be profitable because you are building a habit of not being very systematic when it comes to trading. And if you're not systematic in the sense of how you approach the market, it is almost impossible for you to be consistent. Okay, so the worst thing about this is that you're building a bad habit. Not so much about the money, okay, as I will talk about in outcome number four, it's actually better that a bad trade loses money because you can learn a lesson from it and it is painful. But in outcome number three, when you have a bad trade that wins money, it kind of prime you that, okay, this is the right thing to do. I should do more of this. And when that happens, it's going to be very hard for you to change your habit. Okay, perhaps you are a trader, you've been trading sometime and you realize, you know what to do, but you don't do it. Why is it so? It's because of your habit. It's because you haven't conditioned yourself. You haven't trained yourself up to approach trading in a systematic manner. Okay, so this outcome number three is something that you want to eliminate as much as possible. Now, last outcome, which is outcome number four. It is the bad trade that loses money. So in this case, you didn't follow your trading plan. And same thing as always, you wanted some action and you were bored. Now, in this case, price traded against you and you lost money. Now, this is actually a very good thing because there is an element of loss, there's element of pain, right? You are motivated not to do it again compared to outcome number three where you are motivated to do it again. So in this case, you lost money. What can you do about it? Now, if this happens to you, you already paid a price for this lesson. The next best thing that you can do is to learn from it, okay? Learn from it. Don't do it again. Stop doing this, okay? Stop trading in a haphazard manner. This is what you need to take away from this outcome. You really paid the price. It's kind of like, let's say you have a son and you send your son for a tuition, to a private tutor, and you pay money for your son to learn, but your son refuses to learn. Would you feel frustrated? You definitely will feel frustrated because you paid a price, but he's not learning a lesson. So it's the same thing for you. You already paid the price for it. So why miss the lesson? Right? Make sure you do not do this again. Okay, so hopefully you want to eliminate outcome three as much as possible. Outcome number four, you also want to eliminate. Okay, but outcome three is definitely worse than outcome four, because outcome four, you are incentivized not to do it again. But for outcome number three, you're incentivized to do it again because you want money. So here's my bonus tip. How do you know your trades? Like, let's say you're looking at your trades. How do you know which type of outcome is each of your trades, under? You know, which, let's say you took this trade, what type of trade? Is this a good trade that made money? Okay, so the first thing that you're going to need is you need to have a trading plan. Again, if you are new to trading and you do not have a step-by-step way to approach the market, we have this for you over here. Okay, it's free. There's really no reason why you don't have this. Okay, it's free. We made it free. We really invested a lot of time to create this guide for you. It's, I think, about 35 pages. There's really no reason why you should not have a trading plan, especially if you've been following us for some time, you've been watching our videos, you've been in our Telegram channel. You need to have this. Okay, please, I can't stress this enough. Please have this trading plan. Okay, you need to have a trading plan that has your trade set up, meaning that you must know for a fact that, okay, under this scenario, I'm going to buy. Under that scenario, I'm going to sell. You must be very clear. Then, once you have this, you need to ask yourself, when you're looking at your trades, meaning that after the trade has concluded, ask yourself, did you follow your trading plan? It's a very simple question. Okay, so if the answer is yes, then regardless of the outcome, it is a good trade. Okay, I don't care if the trade made money or it lost money. It is a good trade because you stick to your trading plan. Of course, if you want to determine whether it's a good trade that made money or a good trade that lost money, just look at the P&L of that trade. If that trade win money, then of course it's a good trade that win money. And of course, if the trade lose money, then it's a good trade that lost money. The opposite is also true. If you did not follow your trading plan, then regardless of the outcome, okay, again, I stress, regardless of the outcome, it is still a bad trade. I don't care if that trade, you made $20,000, you made $100,000, it is still a bad trade. And you need to eliminate this kind of trade from your trading, okay? You cannot trade against your rules. You need to stick to your rules if you want to become a professional trader and you want to be successful in the long term. Okay, so if you did not follow your trading plan, then this is a bad trade. Okay, of course, if the bad trade earns you money, then of course it's a bad trade that wins money. If it loses money, then it's a bad trade that loses money. Okay, so you want to avoid bad trades as much as possible. Your job as a trader is just to take good trades, whether it's a win or lose, that's up to the market, that's beyond your control. But what is within your control is whether your trades were executed according to your trading plan. Okay, so hopefully you got value out of this. So I have just four examples here just to run it through, just so that you understand. So let's say scenario number one, you follow your trade plan and made $100. Okay, this is a good trade that win money because you followed trading plan. Okay, number two, it's also the same. You followed trading plan and you lost money. Okay, but it's still a good trade because you followed trading plan. Number three, you didn't follow trading plan. So this is the bad trade and you made $100. So you won money. Okay, this is a bad thing. You shouldn't be having this kind of trades in your trading journal, okay? And number four, the last one, you didn't follow again, so it's a bad trade and you lose $100, okay? This is where you want to avoid it and you want to take a lesson from it and not repeat this mistake. Okay, so hopefully this lesson has been helpful for you. I really hope that you really analyze your trades and you try to stick towards outcome number one and outcome number two. Okay, just a brief recap. I started this video talking about why you need to know the correct outcome. Basically, the Forex or any form of trading is never black or white. So you need to really understand whether is this a good trade or is this a bad trade. Okay, just because you made money doesn't mean it's a good trade, and just because you lost money doesn't mean it's a bad trade. So I have four outcomes for you over here that I went through. And I also showed you a bonus tip on how to know for sure what type of outcome your trade falls under. Basically, you ask yourself if you follow your trading plan. Okay, if the answer is yes, then it is a good trade. It's straightforward, a good trade. Whether it wins money or lose money is either outcome one or outcome two. Now, if you did not follow your trading plan, then it automatically becomes a bad trade. And depending on the outcome of the trade, you either won money or you lost money. So hopefully this is clear. As always, if you have any questions, we love to answer any questions you have. Just leave a comment down below. Right. At the same time, please give us a thumbs up. Really appreciate it. Hit the subscribe button. Okay. Do check out our other videos. We have a lot of other videos such as this to help you. If you have any questions, just check our channel for our videos and see if any of this videos address your question. If not, let us know in the comments below, because we will record a video just to address your question if we find that it's a question that that really needs addressing, or some misconception that you have that's very important that we correct. Okay, we'll just record videos specifically for you. Okay, if not, thanks for watching. Hope you have a good weekend. I'll see you in the next video.